Thank you, Mr. President. I wanted to thank the sponsor, Senator O'Meara, for recognizing Earth Day. It is so important, and I stand here as the ranking member of the Environmental Conservation Committee, that we be mindful as public policymakers of the solemn responsibility to be good stewards for our planet, whether it be my four-year-old daughter or Elliot up there or our kids or our grandchildren. But we truly also should take this opportunity to recognize that we need to do more. Now, there are some interesting bills, Mr. President, on the calendar today: hunting and fishing in schools, repealing safety tags for hunters, repealing fees for hunting licenses, permitting live restraint cables for the capture of wild animals, extending striped bass fishing season, protecting personal information on hunting licenses. There's so many hunting and fishing bills on the calendar today that you'd think Elmer Fudd had some sort of hand in getting bills to the floor. But beyond that, I think it's important, Mr. President, that we also acknowledge something that I think was an oversight in the resolution, which I feel obligated to point out, that there is no mention of climate change. The two words climate change do not appear in the resolution. And I think that's an oversight. It has to be. This is Earth Day, not Flat Earth Day. And the science, Mr. President, is clear. Here are some facts, if I could have a couple of minutes, from the New York City Panel on Climate Change and the UN's Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. Temperature has risen from 1900 to the year 2013 by 0.3 degrees per decade, amounting to a total of 3.4 degrees increase in that time. Global climate models project that mean annual temperatures in New York City alone will increase by 4.1 degrees to 5.7 degrees Fahrenheit by 2050, when Elliot and my daughter are well into their middle ages. Precipitation from 1900 to 2013, the mean annual precipitation in Central Park has increased at a rate of about 0.8 inches per decade. That's a total increase in just that amount of time of 8 inches. Sea level rise and flooding. Sea level in New York City is projected to rise from 11 to 21 inches by the 2050s, 18 to 39 inches by 2080, and it could reach as high as 6 feet 20 years beyond that. New York City's flood zone is projected to double over the next 80 years to cover 100 square miles of the city. That's 100 square miles of the most densely populated city on Earth. And extreme weather, we've all experienced it. The frequency of heat waves is projected to triple by the 2080s, and extreme cold events are projected to decrease as well. So there are warning signs with species. Both warm water, coral reef, and Arctic ecosystems are already experiencing irreversible regime shifts, and these risks are increasing as temperatures increase. And we should be mindful of the economic impact of climate change. With extreme weather events predicted to increase, we have to be prepared for economic impacts, including infrastructure damage, rebuilding costs. The direct cost of Superstorm Sandy alone was $71.4 billion. That's the second costliest storm in history after Katrina. Now, this is kind of like a slow-moving disaster movie, and you might not see the lamp of the Statue of Liberty jutting out of the sand like you did in Planet of the Apes, but we are dooming our children's future unless we act now. Now, the People's Climate March, I think a lot of us attended that. 350,000 people attended it. It was in my district less than a year ago. But what have we done to address it? Where is New York State's climate action plan? Who's in charge of climate change in New York State? Can you name that person? I can't. Next week, the Pope is going to be hosting a summit called Protect the Earth, Dignify Humanity at the Vatican on climate change with the United Nations and experts in global warming. And His Holiness is going to issue an encyclical sometime this summer. He's coming, the Pope is coming to New York City to address the UN on September 22nd. Are we going to be ready to provide him with New York State's climate action plan? Mr. President, I support this resolution, but urge my colleagues, as we move forward in this legislative session, to take decisive steps to reverse global warming and climate change. Thank you, Mr. President.